Hello, welcome back. Now, last time I painted all these blue scales on, or at least indicated where the blue scales are, but I really should have been a bit more careful with the by doing the background first, because the background's darker than the scales. And I don't want the hassle of going round every last little one, that'll take forever. So, my choices are just take my losses and paint over the whole thing with a brush, or try and do it with an airbrush, because the airbrush would be a little bit more subtle and I might still get to see the scales underneath, so I won't totally lose them. Well, let's see, give it a go. It's actually quite dark, so I need blue and dark with some black. I'll mix it directly in the airbrush. See what that looks like. Be a bit darker than that. Right, let's give that a go. I might just get away with it. I can still see the scales I painted last week. Keep going. I'm constantly spraying nothing, because what can sometimes happen is the paint builds up on the end of the needle, and while you're spraying, it suddenly splatters. So regularly, I'm just putting the lever forward and blasting some air into nowhere, which would knock that little droplet of paint off if it's there, and it'll drop it off into somewhere safe. very patchy colours in this part of the lizard. So while I've got the airbrush going, I'll indicate those. Do the job, and I can still see the scales I painted last week, so that's good. Must clean the airbrush. Now I'm looking at the yellow scales and seeing what kind of colours are of around the scales. It's pretty yellow. As you might imagine, it's darker yellow in the shadows. And you can barely see the scales when where it's in the light. So I'm gonna mix up the yellow with some ochre to darken it. Oh, hello. Can you see the paint is St. Petersburg watercolours, and the only other thing I will use with it is this little tube of white gouache when I need the paint opaque, which I'm actually going to add a tiny amount to this yellow to make, just to make it a little bit opaque. Yes, it's, I say, apart from the white gouache, it is watercolour. Put a bit of raw sienna in there to make it a bit darker still. Let's have a look at that. I need glasses for the scales. This brush is probably, yeah, that brush is far too big. I have to use this one. See, that's too watery. More pigment in there. All right, give that a go. scales are very small around his head. Some of these are a lot darker than I'm doing here. I just want to put the scales in so it to indicate their position, and then I can adjust their colour later. I'm not worried too much about putting the scales in the precise position I see in the reference photo, because I'm sure every single lizard's scale pattern is slightly different. So I'm just going for the feel of it. And adding that a little touch of that gouache to the mix means this yellow is covering over the darker colours quite well. Though it will go darker when it's dried. That is the irritating thing about watercolour, and especially gouache. It dries a lot darker. So you have to keep that in mind. As the scales go further back, they are getting bigger. some reason amongst the blue scales is the odd yellow one. The odd partial yellow one. I suppose it all adds to the effect of I'm poisonous, don't touch me. I don't know if this Filipino monitor lizard is actually poisonous or it's one of these ones that are fake and they pretend they are. It was like at a moment I'm painting it like pointillism, doing a Seurat painting. use that colour just to define the edge of his mouth where it catches the light. Something very therapeutic about painting little dots like this. A lot of these scales on the underside here will be far too bright, but I'm not worried about that as I will knock them back with the airbrush at a later date. Weird thing about these scales is a lot of them are blue with a little yellow spot in the middle. need a bit more. Pretty much run out, yeah. On top of here, it wants to be quite bright. We need to go beyond that because that's gonna the frame will cut that off. Hello, Max. You're very welcome. Right, I think I'll start doing some of these lighter blue ones. So use the I might use the same background blue I airbrushed earlier. And the blue ones that caught the light a little bit.
Right. There's a few of these flowers that are almost white. Right, I'm slightly over time. Just want to put these in.
And what I plan to do next week is the final details. Assess what I've done today, fix things that need fixing, and put the final details in, then I'll call it done. I think that'll do for today. I need to sit back and assess what I've done. There's that leg's looking far too flat. I've got to get it rounded. But I can fix some of this with the airbrush, and there's lots of shadows in there I've now need to re-establish. So please join me next week and see the final results. Thank you for watching. Bye.